Hello, poker fans, and welcome to another episode of Windy City Poker Championship. I'm your executive producer, Kirk Falla, and boy, are you in for a treat as we bring you the highlights from the Shady Oaks Camp $1,000 main event, which was hosted on location at Southwest Community Services in Tinley Park. This event gave every player a chance to play at the TV table, and it gave us a chance to introduce you to several on-air personalities, including Scott Long from Annie Up Magazine, Jason Salmon, PokerTel's expert, Zach Elwood, myself, of course, and who knows, Jason Finn might pop into the booth. Hopefully not. Let's get to the first hour of coverage at our feature table.
100 to call.
All right, cards are in the air. I've always never wanted to say that.
We got Larry first act here.
Balls 100.
And he's throwing them away.
Balls 100. Balls.
Balls. Love this RFID technology.
Ways to 1,000.
Pretty amazing.
Cards right away.
I don't think you're allowed to do that first hand, Ron.
Ron's going to raise to 1,000.
Big ace king. Well, he's starting out ahead. That's always important.
All right, we'll give him a little action first.
All right.
Perfect. Perfect. I got him right where they want me.
Three players.
I check.
That's an interesting flop there, Scott.
This is going to be a fun hand, I think.
Essentially,
flush draw, straight draw with a top pair, top kicker.
It's going to be a good one. Maybe we'll have an out in the first hand.
We'll be home by dinner.
Sounds good.
Heads up. I feel like those 40,000 chips aren't going to last me very long.
Check.
Check. Six. 6,000.
Things looking better for Joel.
Let's see a final card.
And he makes the call.
Big river now. Oh, wow.
Check.
What a river card.
Let's see what Ron does. We got check, check.
Oh, check, check.
Interesting. Playing a little timid at the beginning of this one.
Splashed around with 7-8 suited, hits, and then gets cautious on the river. All right. Nice pot, though.
Yep. To each his own.
21,000 or so.
I'm consistent.
So Jason, this is your first time in Chicago.
This is my first time in Chicago. I got to try the famous deep dish pizza last night. It was pretty amazing.
The best part of the deep dish pizza, it's indoors.
Yeah, it's quite an experience with the weather here coming from Tampa, Florida.
For a couple of Floridians, this is not primo weather for us.
We almost didn't make it in today.
Oh my gosh, Joel, another connected hand. At least it's not suited this time.
We got some similar hands coming in on this one.
Raise to 600.
I think I'm going to want to see a 9 on this flop.
That would sound like a good one. Pretty much any middle straight cards.
Calls.
Weeded out the competition.
Oh, yeah.
Five players.
I need five pair here. So intimidating.
Lots of people want to play in this tournament.
I think the structure is key on that. You have David flop the nuts right now.
Check.
Check.
I get $2,500.
$2,500.
$10,000.
Raise to 10,000.
I knew I'm gonna like having somebody at the table like you.
I'm happy to take the 2,500, my friend. We don't have to go any further.
I think he wants to win this one right now.
No longer have the luxury of losing 400 hands in a row.
Come on. If anybody's going to play 3-6, it's going to be Joel. But not going to oblige this time.
Raise to 300.
Paul raises it up.
He didn't want to get off the boat.
Yeah.
And to try to get the captain's hat back on.
Raise to 1,200.
You're like,
he held on to the captain's hat in the meantime.
Tracy, you want to go have you wash the hat?
1,200 all day. Your call. Heads up.
Oh, wow.
Wow. Jason has to think he could be good here.
Yes.
$1,300.
And you never like the less than 1% graphic on the screen when
it's
you're
not the most
cards,
fun one.
Right?
If only he could see what we see. The only thing is, there is a chance here that Jason could re-raise, thinking that he's just trying, someone's just trying to push
true.
Him out of the pot. So maybe he's on another level than we were even thinking. Not this time.
The remainder of the hand to you.
Call, you might have seen.
Yes, no, I seeded the hand. Seeded. I retreat.
This portion of the show is brought to you by Rental Max in Orland Park, Illinois. Rental Max has a full line of Bobcats available. You can rent skid steers, excavators, and tree stump grinders. Look to Rental Max to help you out with all of your landscaping needs, including aerial rentals, boom lifts, and so much more. And of course, they have trucks available for your next major move or project. Call 708-535-5080 or search online for Rental Max Orland Park.
No way. I don't have enough.
Structure is so important in tournaments. That's why I really think players really need to come out to events like this.
It's funny how many of the recreational players don't pay attention to the structure.
That's
all they
true.
Care about is the number of chips they start with. And that actually has nothing to do with anything, right?
Not even a little bit. You start with 6 million chips, but if the big blind is 1 million, it's not incredibly helpful.
Exactly.
Now I'm nervous.
$550
now raised. What I like about the 9-5 suited though is if it hits, it hits.
No one thinks you have it.
Exactly. If it doesn't hit, it's easy to throw away.
Jason, not having incredible luck when he decides to raise. Zach will probably re-raise here.
I'm going to say it's definitely a re-raise coming here. So hard to do with a big blind though, because that flop is so brutal, right?
It always is.
1600.
There's always one higher than your pocket pair.
Does make it 1600 to go.
Joel's out. Mike's out. What's Jason gonna do here?
Poor Jason. There's two left feet this tournament, right?
And he calls.
Heads up.
He's going to be an action killer, though.
Nope, but still an interesting flop. You got backdoor flush draw, straight draw.
Enough here to keep Jason in, I think.
Actually, the same odds as when he started the hand.
Yeah.
I guess you did say shit in front of me. You did say that. You didn't know he was there when you pulled it.
Right. Yeah. I didn't know he was
there.
I was just looking at your chip stack.
1300.
No, I knew he was there. I mean, I knew he called.
I think you gotta stay if you're Jason here.
Zach is a tells expert though, so maybe he's picking up something.
Oh.
Check.
It's such an inducing type of check.
He's not gonna like it before ace comes, but.
This is true. At least he didn't get the backdoor flush draw on the turn.
And now what do you do, though?
I think you got to wait a few seconds there to make that call.
If you're going to raise now, though.
That's a good point.
He's got to think he's best, right?
It's a very good point. You're not really inducing to try to go to the river.
He's
and
you
have the call.
Very
this
interesting.
Is interesting. I'll have to make sure I watch out for Zach there on the felt. Interesting play there on that hand, Scott.
Yeah, Jason just couldn't pull the trigger there in the end.
Yeah, player started with 40,000 chips. 400 big blinds to start.
Very nice.
You never know, though. It's still easy to spew away some chips sometimes, big or little stack.
Raise to 300.
Again, they can rebuy for 500, correct?
Yeah, 500 plus 30 for a full stack, first 8 levels.
And of course, part of that rebuy benefits the Shady Oaks camp.
18.5% is the rake for the buy-in, so it's very fair compared to tournaments at casinos.
And it benefits a lot better than a casino.
Exactly. We like to let the players know where the money goes, how much goes where, and you know, when you're going to buy in for a buy-in like this, we're going to give you a good value. Get to play cards all day. Of course, one of the things a lot of people ask is, you know, it's a charity event. Do I win cash? What, you know, do I win prizes? What's the deal? Well, the Illinois Charitable Games Act only allows for $500 in cash above your original buy-in. So you could physically walk out with 500 in cash winnings, but the rest of it is a shopping spree. What do you want? Are you going to play the circuit event? Are you going to go out to Vegas? Are you going to fly? You got a cell phone bill. You know, basically anything that can award a gift card is what is allowable as a prize. So rather than forcing you to take a prize, the players get their option to pick and choose, and it's worked out very well the last couple of years.
Excellent.
Three players.
All in.
All in.
I call.
All in. Call.
Well. Wow.
Ron is he's in some serious trouble here.
Somebody has a lunch reservation.
Table for Ron.
Well, I think I might have to go get a rebuy ready for him.
And Joel is considering this call.
Wow.
Good luck to you. Good luck to you. I talked to Ron earlier.
All right, that's fair.
Well, you clearly got me beat.
You have King Jack, right?
No, I'm on a draw. I'm on a draw. I'm on the bigger draw. I had top pair and open-ended straight.
Here we go, guys.
And you were there.
Straight. Not gonna do it.
Not it.
And Ron is our first elimination here from the TV table.
Although he's not eliminated until he decides not to donate more to charity.
I just called on the miracle draw and it came in.
Well, if you're anything but a straight, I might get you off the hand.
Obviously, anything
but a straight.
And I was still worried you had King Jack, which is why I didn't go shove, because before he had King Jack, then I'm really.
You don't like full houses or anything, do you?
No.
Never had one.
No, I'll let you know if I ever had one.
Never.
I'll fold it.
Call it's 150.
What's the bad beat here? 500.
Raise to 500.
I'm gonna play the rush.
Oh, that's good.
All right.
Three players.
Once again, a smattering of cruddy hands. We'll be surprised. Oh, I was just going to say, it'd be surprising to see an ace in this flop.
And there
how
it
wrong
is.
I was. And not only that, but two pair hands.
3,000.
It's a great position for Joel to be in here. I think there's a lot of money to be made in this pot, especially two of the largest chip stacks playing each other.
Yes.
I think this could be a good way to finish out our first hour of TV table.
Because when you have these ace rag hands, that's the best thing right ever, to see that
it is the
that
best.
Rag on there.
I'm on a club draw.
Raise the 15,500.
That make that decision easy?
Yeah.
He's got a lot of chips. Not much of a straight right there. I don't think he's holding 3-4. Go ahead. I'm all in. I got a set of eights. That's all I can do is a set of eights. I guess. You got me covered, right?
No, you had to double up through Ron. No. You'll have plenty of chips left.
I like how you got a needle in. You needled Ron on the side there.
I didn't miss it. Yeah, it didn't go on the first.
That eliminates that.
So I mean, he's full.
Ace eight.
On this hand, you are an 8-minute break. Players, Better call.
There it is.
The call.
So close to folding, and there it is.
That's gonna hurt. That's gonna hurt the morning, folks.
Wow.
Less.
Yeah. Is it? Well.
Wow.
Did you pull the ace?
That was a fun way to end this this first hour here.
This broadcast brought to you in high definition by the Little Guys Home Technology. More knowledge, more experience, better results. That's the Little Guys. 191st in LaGrange, just off I-80 in Mokena, or at thelittleguys.com.
We are on location at Southwest Community Services in Tinley Park. Let's get to the coverage from the second hour of the feature table.
Kurt, and speaking of that, we hear Rebuy in the background. More money for the charity. We like that. Ben's going to raise a 700 with a suited one gapper from the cutoff. Jason, who was just doing commentary with me, it looks like he's going to make the call. As is Mike in the big blind.
Everybody's scared of me. Four callers.
Yeah.
Words out.
Yeah.
Five players.
You're right, Ben. No one's scared. Not now, at least. Two jacks, two spades on this board. No one has any jacks. Mike made a curious limp call to raise from another gun, has two spades. And then hits his flush. Check. He's going to check it, see if he can induce a bet from Ben.
900.
And he does get a bet. Jason, of course, has the ace of spades, so he has the redraw here.
There it is. I knew it was coming.
Raise to 25.
And makes a big raise, 2,500.
Call.
Mike's going to call this flush. And Ben, with just that pair there, has to be worried now. And smartly folds. And we'll see whether this river brings a spade or not. It doesn't, so Mike will win this hand unless Jason keeps the pressure up. It's hard to imagine that Mike is going to fold here.
37's
the bet. Exactly, makes the call. And Jason, of course, knew as soon as that call came that he wasn't good. Imagine he's thinking right now, it's a lot easier being in the booth here doing the commentary than playing with these tough players.
Jason's got ace, queen of hearts. Ace, queen of hearts is back.
And the always deadly jack 10 in the hand.
Pocket pair for Richard. He's going to set mine.
I like how Ben splashes around with all kinds of hands. It's hard to put him on hand. 6-4 here.
Oh my goodness, we got top two against the Royal Flush Draw. This is going to be an action flop.
That's 26. Hold.
Here it comes.
Oh, well,
that's going to make it easier now.
You know what? I think the money's going to get in at some point. Of course, now Jason has even more outs if he's behind.
Exactly.
Which he is.
any king will give him the win. I mean, he's got 16 outs.
Yeah. It's 50-50 right now.
How are we 50-50? This is crazy. The RFID does account for cards that are in the muck, so that does help the equation. Oh, look at this. All right, flip a coin, heads or tails? And it's tails. Jason
wins.
Don's a trooper. He'll stick around, and he's still got what 135 big blinds.
Well, that's just it. That's the way we talked to the entire first hour of this this great event. Is that the structure and the chip stack? No one's really short stacked at all.
And it's not only for the big buy-in tournaments. You know, if you come to Windy City Poker Championship sponsored event, you can play in $60 tournaments that have 40,000 chips to start and 20-minute deep stack structure. You can play in $50 tournaments with 15,000 chips. The rake is really low. The charities only hold 20% rake, and then there's also 4% that goes towards the free rolls. And coincidentally, there's a free roll going on in the back there. The winner is going to get a $1,000 seat, and they're going to sit here at our main event TV table eventually and play. So for $0, you can win $1,000.
Yeah,
not too bad. Oh, see, this is a perfect hand to get after you lose a big pot.
Exactly. Let's just hope he's not steaming and plays it recklessly. I wouldn't think that's it. Although his t-shirt does say play reckless, so.
I think that was part of his table image. I'm going to sit down with a shirt that does not represent who I am as a person. Well, I called. I want to see it. If you're willing to watch it, that's why I do it. You can hear David Wexler in the background from Little Guys Home Technology. We've got microphones at the TV table. You can hear the commentary from the players along with us. It's always great to hear what the players have to say, especially early on in the tournament. But these players are really serious. I mean, there's over 50 players in the tournament, already a couple rebuys.
Raise 31.
And, okay, David Baldwin's going to re-raise to 31. I think Don's going to ship it here. It's going to be an all-in and a call. Don's not going to want to call here and see an ace. He wants to see all five cards.
Raise.
Yeah.
21-2.
Just left bus fare behind. This guy went about 6,000-7,000 behind.
Yeah.
Players all in.
All right. Easy all call. Call. Yep, absolutely. Turn them up, folks. And of course, the big favor. Well, one king is in the muck, so.
One ace is in the muck also.
This is ace queen.
Wow.
Oh, two rivers in a row, and Don is crippled.
Yeah. I invite him to Chicago to come play poker, and what happens? He gets schooled twice at the TV table.
Southwest Community Services is our host. Shady Oaks Camp is our beneficiary. Both of these two organizations do great work for adults and children with disabilities. All these players playing today are contributing to that cause. No hands to ride her home about yet. David, who likes to play a lot of different hands, is going to make a call with 4-7 of spades.
3 minutes. In 3 minutes, we will take an 8-minute break.
And now, Mike in the small blind, pocket jacks. Very difficult hand to play in the most difficult position to play it.
Raise to 700.
We'll see how frisky David wants to get. Get a call with a substandard hole hand, but he's going to play the player instead. He's going to make a raise. And Mike Hayes is going to come along. Now the question, does Mike P want to raise here? David didn't raise. Davis was a check raise, so. Just makes a call, three-handed. Not what you want with jacks. You like to be heads up.
Three players.
Especially in the worst position. But a great flop for jacks. 3-7-5. David's going to like it too. Splashing around to 7-4 actually hits top pair. But we probably will be heads up.
That's
going to the turn.
Raise. 6,000. Last hand feature table, guys.
Last hand. Mike does want to chance it. Raises to 6,000. It's going to be a difficult call for David to make. But he does. Oh, and wow. What a turn card for David.
That's 10,000.
So unfortunate for Mike P here.
What do you got left, Mike?
Raise is expected here. Could be a shove.
Players all in.
All in. Yeah, we thought that was coming.
I call.
Yeah, it's a call. Saw that coming as well, too. He's down to two outs. Going to need a jack. What a tough way to go out in the last hand for the break. Queen, no help.
The all-in moments on the Windy City Poker Championship are brought to you by Joel Schaub at Guaranteed Rate. His all-in pricing has a $350 flat lender fee that covers everything, including underwriting, processing, and appraisal for your property. Joel has thousands of very satisfied clients. So to purchase or refi for just $350 or talk to him directly, call 773-654-2049 or log on to guaranteedrate.com/Joel Schaub. We are on location at Southwest Community Services in Tinley Park. Let's get to the coverage from the third hour of the feature table.
Raise to 800. Calls 800.
Maybe we'll play better poker than what we were doing over there. No more bingo poker, huh?
Yeah. All in.
All in.
What were you saying? What were you saying?
You talked a little too soon there, Brian.
Right. It's my first time on TV playing poker. I gotta do it.
I really
want
to. Gotta show off for the cameras, right, Keith?
The most hated man at the poker table is right here.
What are you talking about? Not even close.
I know he's gonna catch something.
Not even close.
Guess the hand and I'll show.
Southern deuce. Queens.
Give this man the hookabar.
My man, toss me a quarter.
What was it?
To me. That's the four of us.
Do you turn him over?
Yeah, queens he showed.
Doesn't appear anybody wants this pot.
I'll take it.
Fold to the button. Tyler's going to take a stab, it looks like, with his seven deuce. The hammer. Jack five. Tony's going to make the call.
Heads up.
Queen trade jack. Nice flop for Tony.
Check.
They're going to keep the pressure on.
1150.
Tony not scared. Deuce clubs. Gives Tyler a pair of deuces. A little more power to continue up his ruse.
37.
Then he's going to make the call. Just not a believer, which is good, because he shouldn't be. And the river's a tray.
It's a what?
Tray. 61.
A three?
Tray.
Three?
Tray.
You and Jason Finn with these different ways of talking about things in numbers. What's the third one? Third card. Is that a yak or a jack?
That would be a jack.
Yakety yak? I call it a yak. I got pocket yaks.
And a call.
Oh. And a nice call.
Jackson threes.
I have like the worst.
Maybe I should pay attention. Raise to 1,025.
I raise. Bob's gonna make a raise from the button.
Make it 34.
Mike gonna re-raise in the big blind. 7-8 off.
Hey Tony,
you got me on two.
I have like the worst position.
Can we just like go like slap that thing around a few times?
All right, I'll give you a chance to get some of your money back.
Thank you, Bob.
You said it so nicely, so I figure I'll give you a shot at it. I always give people a shot.
Seven jack deuce, two clubs.
5,000.
Good flop from Mike, he thinks. Unfortunately, Bob has the jack. Turn no help. Mike keeps pressure up. Bob is going to call. River's the 10 of spades. That locks it up for Bob.
15,000,
pretty substantial bet here on the river.
Nice call.
Nice call.
Who's got this?
Bob's gonna make the call.
Sevens. Bear
nice. Taking a 67,000 unit pot. Chunk hands all around so far until Keith with big slick.
Ooh, there we go. There's a tell for you. 22.
2,200.
That is 2,200.
And a call.
Tyler's going to call with ace jack, dominated. And one of his jacks is in Mike's hand right now.
I'd play it.
Something to play mine. That's up.
Check.
Check.
Ryan, what are you doing walking
in? 3,000? Shaking it off.
This chain chair is just like a little bit. Yeah. A little bit.
I like it.
I have no idea what I just did here.
Seemingly good flop for Tyler.
It's like one, but there.
Kurt, if you put some tape on it, I'm sure it will work just fine.
Gosh, tape will work just fine, yeah. Alright, I just took like 35 photos.
You want in the back? Yeah.
Raise to 40,000.
This 40, Key? 5,000, 40,000. I love it. You, sir, are my favorite person in the whole world.
There you go.
You're now somebody's favorite person.
Better tweet that.
Yeah, better tweet that out. Somebody's favorite person.
The all-in moments on the Windy City Poker Championship are brought to you by Joel Schaub at Guaranteed Rate. His all-in pricing has a $350 flat lender fee that covers everything, including underwriting, processing, and appraisal for your property. Joel has thousands of very satisfied clients. So to purchase or refi for just $350 or talk to him directly, call 773-654-2049 or log on to guaranteedrate.com/Joel Schaub. We are on location at Southwest Community Services in Tinley Park. Let's get to the coverage from the fourth hour of the feature table.
Kathy gets ace 9 on back-to-back hands.
Most active player so far at the feature table.
This time she's going to raise with it. Steve right behind her with pocket sevens.
Steve Gorski is his name. He's got walking sticks.
Huh?
Coincidentally, me and my mom had walking sticks recently because we both had knee surgery. I'm up and running around. She's ready to kick some butt.
Cool. Lloyd's going to come along with ace-queen. And Angelo now with ace-king with all this action.
I'm going to take this moment, since everyone's watching at this point probably, to let you know that we are here at Southwest Community Services. And Southwest Services, they help those with disabilities help to maximize their development and independence. Opportunities are unlimited. And another program here at SES provides vocational training, paid work, socialization, and case management for adults with intellectual and other developmental disabilities. There are volunteer opportunities available, so if you have time to give or a special skill or talent you'd like to share, then contact them for more information. It's a great organization. We're happy to be a part of this event with them. They also have a Southwest Therapy and Rehab Services in Mokena. Offers free physical, occupational, and speech therapy screenings. Call them today for scheduling. And then, of course, there's bingo on Tuesday nights while we say that the player is all in, which is Steve Gorski. Tuesday nights here at 4:30. Early bird game starts at 6:30. Come play bingo at Southwest Community Services.
There's a bingo going on today, too. I couldn't multitask. Big hand here. Angelo re-raises with ace-king. Gets Kathy out, who was the original raiser. Steve moves all in for $26,000, which is less. Oh, I'm sorry. Yep, it makes the call now.
All in and a call.
Pocket sevens. Where's ace king?
At ace queen.
Classic race, but because of the cards that are already out, we can see that Steve is well in front. Kathy keeping the pressure on. Another race. King Jack this time.
Race to 36. Race to 3,600. You had an ace and he had an ace. There's only one ace, three kings, so four
cards. Lloyd calls it with ace jack, and then Melissa with a pair of sixes makes it 3,600 to go. All right, we're three-handed here. Eight, ten, four. Nothing for anyone, so that's good news for Melissa.
3,000 to bet.
She's gonna bet about a fourth of the pot here. Smallish bet. Likely to get one, if not two, callers based on this board.
Raise to 10,300.
Or Kathy is gonna raise instead. Melissa does make the call. We're gonna see a turn. It's the 10 of diamonds.
Players all in.
Kathy's gonna move all in already. Oh boy, quick call too by Melissa.
Flip your cards, please.
She has to fade. King Jack or eight here on the river, and it's a four, and it's a double up for Melissa.
Welcome to the jungle, guys. Wow.
Very good call.
No one even, wow.
Very good call.
Just, wow. I know, guys, like Gorski, like, he hits jags, doesn't matter, he just moves all in. Like, I can't stand playing.
I guess I was just predicting it.
Chris calls under the gun, queen, 10 of clubs. A lot of junk behind him. Until we get to Leroy. Pocket eights, that's good enough for him to shove his short stack in. Just shy of 18,000 is the bet. Would be a significant part of Chris's stack. Leroy could have really anything.
I have a pair. Over the hill.
Yeah. He's going to make that call?
Go over the hill and make a left turn at 83rd. There's a Speedway gas station there.
Leroy is hoping for a little better odds. Right now he's 54-46. Ace of clubs on the board.
Hopefully he's a club to get a sweat out of it.
Leroy's going to double up.
But I have that hand that's like any flop. If I don't hit my set, like what do I do?
Yeah, exactly.
And unfortunately, I was in that position too, where I didn't know what to do, like in the middle.
After his double up, Leroy looks down at two black tens.
25.
To make it 2,500 to go.
25 and a call.
Seth with king, queen, small blind, was tempted to call and does. And Chris the same way, suited ace five in the big blind. Got pocket tens, you never want to see a paint, definitely not in this hand. And that is wonderful for Leroy. He's going to slow play that top set. No real danger on board.
2,500.
Seth picks up a gut shot and he's going to bet it out. Chris doesn't believe anybody. He's got a pair of fives.
82.
Leroy's going to, as expected, raise to 8,200. And now everybody's going to reassess. At what point did Leroy like this hand? Seth concedes he was just trying to steal that pot. It's going to get out of the way.
Oh, man, I knew I should
have. How do you have that tail? Oh my God, how do you have that there? How is that possible?
I could not just call both of them either.
The all-in moments on the Windy City Poker Championship are brought to you by Joel Schaub at Guaranteed Rate. His all-in pricing has a $350 flat lender fee that covers everything, including underwriting, processing, and appraisal for your property. Joel has thousands of very satisfied clients. So to purchase or refi for just $350 or talk to him directly, call 773-654-2049 or log on to guaranteedrate.com/Joel Schaub.
Lightning doesn't strike in the same place twice.
We are on location at Southwest Community Services in Tinley Park. Let's get to the coverage from the fifth hour of the feature table.
You're going to show with a decent ass. The only reason I'm asking.
Donated $1,000
to
you last time.
Oh, yeah. I deserve it.
Raise to 3,000. Raise to 11,500. That's up.
I
Bet 17,000.
It's an excellent board for Bill. He might be able to get away from this at some point. Right now, he probably doesn't think he wants to. He's got the chips to do it.
Wow.
Very disciplined lay down.
I don't think my will is that strong every time.
And tens.
Wow. Two honest poker players at the same table.
Could have had some redemption.
Yeah.
Richie waking up here with an ace, ten of spades.
3,000 now.
And he makes it 3,000 to go.
You had experience with ace 10 at the feature table today.
I did.
It's not a pleasant one, I don't remember.
It was not a pleasant one. Ace queen, much more pleasant. But ace 10, not so much.
Ace 2 is trouble. And he gets away from it.
Oh.
Everybody's thinking about all the blinds they stole. That's what it is.
Heads up.
It's like serious poker over here. Yeah, this is serious poker.
Flops a set. Yeah, it's
going to
be tough to beat.
It's pretty dry for Richie. Let's see if he bets out. And he looks like he is taking the bait.
4,500.
I gotta think you smooth call here, being Dave.
Absolutely. No reason to raise here. No danger on this board.
We get the call.
Check.
Insta fold. Must have had a feeling there.
Yeah.
A good.
First you put him on a king, it wouldn't matter. So.
A good feeling by Richie there, getting away from the hand.
They had a player down. Had a player down on the outside tables.
3,000 now. Calls through.
Raise it up. Raise. Make it 15,000 now.
A raise to 15,000. That's quite a large raise. That raise means please don't call me.
Well, as you know, he's up against two pocket pairs.
We are counting down stacks here.
Yeah, this is a tough spot to be under the gun with a small pocket pair.
I think if he reshoves anyway, I think Dave is coming along for the ride.
Yeah, exactly.
I think it's a race. I don't think you got a pair, but I pull.
Buys now 600, 1,200.
12 to call, guys. 12
with the Benjamin as an ante.
Raise to 3,600.
Even with a corrected chip stack, I think I still would have shoved if I was Richie there.
You got to get him in. That small raise, two people call with pocket pairs, you go to a flop, you just there's no equity there.
I'm all in.
All in. Gotta call.
He's gonna need some help.
This is for Richie's tournament life.
King or some hearts, but not too many hearts.
We go to the flop.
Oof, not
no
good
help,
at all.
No help for Richie. This is not going to be Richie's day. Richie has been eliminated from the tournament.
Nice playing, Leon.
As we said before, no more rebuys, entries, anything like that.
We are down to seven players at this feature table.
Could have been mean and limpy.
Dan picking up a ace nine here.
She was gonna make a call with ten eight of hearts. Dave considering it with two connectors. It's decides against it.
Oh, Bill waking up.
Ship leader of kings. Don't like that.
Better call.
Yeah, the jack 10. Hard to get away from, folks. So hard to get away from.
Scott is speaking from direct experience here.
Never won a hand with jack 10, ever.
But I'm now a lot more interested
and
to play.
Never
you.
Folded it either. David has one of Bill's outs.
Probably better that you do.
I don't know. I'm going to see at least I'm going to see everything.
There you go.
All right, we're going to get a good hand here towards the end of this hour. Nine. It's an open ender there for Dave.
10,000.
Gut shot for Joe.
Just a little bit more.
Bill's still in the lead.
All
here.
In. Okay. All you can eat, baby.
Whoa.
And
he's gonna easily get called here by Bill.
Dave.
Call.
Yep.
That's the instant call we were seeing.
Of course, one of the outs he needs is a king, and three of them are already out, so.
He got two of his outs.
One of my cards.
Down to a 21% favorite. Nine's not going to be one of them. I need an eight.
And he did not get there. And Bill will increase his chip stack there. That will be all she wrote for Dave.
Well, that wraps up this episode from the Shady Oaks Camp Charity Poker Event. Join us next week for more feature table action and the conclusion of this unique event. On behalf of Shady Oaks Camp, Southwest Community Services, and everybody at Windy City Poker Championship, I'm Kirk Falla. We'll see you next week.